The third season of Stranger Things is now on Netflix, so that means it's time to rank the seasons from worst to best. Hey everybody, my name is Justin. I love to watch movies and, of course, Stranger Things. If you guys can relate, you guys are in the right spot. Make sure to hit that subscribe button down below so you guys don't miss any of my up-and-coming videos. Today we're going to rank all three of the seasons of Stranger Things. I love each one of these seasons in a different way, but after watching season three, I have a clear choice of which one is my favorite and which one is my least favorite. So before we do get started with this video, I'd like for you guys to get in the comment section down below and how would you rank all three of these seasons from worst to best. The season started in 2016, I believe, and then we had 2017 and then 2019. So with that, let's rank these seasons from worst to best, starting in at number three, the worst season, but still a pretty good season, is Stranger Things season two. Here we got the introduction of Billy and Max, and I thought they fit well into the story. Billy, not so much. I really did not care for Billy as the antagonist in season two, but my viewpoint did change for Billy in season three. And I did enjoy Max. I think that she worked well into the story with Dustin, Lucas, Will, and Mike, and Eleven as well. One thing I did appreciate a lot about season two is the fact that Hopper is now in dad mode and he wants to take care of Eleven. He is there for her. And those moments are really sweet. So Stranger Things season two is filled with a lot of sweet moments, especially from Hopper and Eleven. I thought the relationship worked really well. There are some moments though when Eleven is going off on her own and she's trying to learn more about herself and she meets those kids, that like punk kids. I don't think those elements in the story work as other storylines do in the show. Those are easily my least favorite moments of all three of the seasons, really. I did appreciate the fact that they were willing to give her, you know, some more of a backstory, but I think that when it comes down to it, the overall story that, you know, her when going off and meeting these other people, I think came off a bit clunky at times. I think they spent a little too much time on it. But I did appreciate that they were willing to give it a try. I also really enjoyed Steven here. He's my favorite in the series. And I love that he, you know, got attached to these kids and he was completely different from the first season. Mom Steve is easily one of my favorite things about the Stranger Things series. Stranger Things season 2 was not a bad season. I think that they have some really good moments. The relationships really do click in the show. There are some strong cinematic moments at the end and the visuals are stunning once again, but for that storyline with Eleven, it makes season two at the end. Coming at number two is Stranger Things season one. Stranger Things season one was the one that started it all. I think that the show did the best at capturing the friendship amongst these four. We had Dustin, Lucas, Will, and Mike, and Will went missing, and so it was up to the friends to get together with Hopper and Joyce and Jonathan and Nancy and Eleven to try to find Will. And I think that Eleven was so interesting, and she had to learn a lot about like society and life, and it's a good fish out of water story, and I think she fit very well into this group. They like accepted her. They wanted to be her friend, and it was all like really authentic. They captured a realistic way of how friends interact and adopting someone new into your friend group. And so the best thing about Stranger Things season one is easily the friendship that is created by the Duffer brothers and how they handled these four main stars act as friends. And then they had everything else around them that was going on and seeing how they would react to those certain moments, and that's easily the best thing. The visuals are great. I think that this show had a really nice progression, starting to understand more of the Demogorgons and the different things that are going on with Eleven. I think that they did a lot in the show and didn't get lost with the overall message of the show. And coming at number one is Stranger Things Season 3, the most recent season, and I absolutely love this. It took everything I loved about Season 1, the friendships. It took everything I loved about Season 2, Dad, Hopper, and Mom, Steve, and then combined it for Season 3 and gave me more to love, like Robin and Alexi. I loved those characters. They were so cool in this show. And by the third season, you know, they're a little older. There's a little more romance going on. Some friends are still stuck in their certain ways, wanting to play D&D, while others are learning to, you know, move past that. And I think that it's a really realistic approach to friends who've been friends for a while and they're growing up and are trying to move on to different things. I appreciate that. And I also loved the story as well, and by like the fifth episode, it became like, I felt like it was the end. I felt like, you know, they're doing so much in the fifth episode, and then we get to the eighth episode and just all out, like an hour and 17 minute, and I absolutely loved it. The show is really funny. There's so many different storylines going on, but they all eventually come together at the end to fight the monster. And some of the characters that I did not really care about in previous seasons really were well written in Season 3, especially Billy. Did not really care for Billy as the antagonist in Season 2, but in Season 3 he had a lot more to do and I really enjoyed the character. Steve works really well with Robin, and then we also get Erica, who is Lucas's little sister, who has a lot more to do in the show, and she's foul-mouthed. She's fun to watch. The show just did a great job of bringing these friends together, introducing new characters, making you love them. Handling a great story, had a really good progression going for it. The visuals are stunning once again. Season 3 is easily my favorite season of Stranger Things, and I can't wait to see what they do for a fourth season. So there you guys have it, all three of the seasons ranked worst to best. Make sure to check out my video I did right over here. I did a tier list for all the Stranger Things characters. I'd like for you guys to check that out. And stay tuned for more movie reviews coming your way. My name is Just Watch Movies, and you guys stay classy, YouTube.